Welcome to the show that takes you behind the scenes at the last family-owned and run theme park and zoo in the UK, Flamingo Land in North Yorkshire. We'll be following all the ups and downs and thrills and spells of the countdown to the opening of the park for the 2006 season. And stay tuned for the chance to win a family break in Teesdale in our competition. The park's new attraction for 2006 is a roller coaster costing £6 million. The boss's wife, Victoria Gibb, who also works at the park and is expecting her first baby in less than a month, hasn't gone on maternity leave yet.
This is the site of our newest and most beautiful roller coaster to date. It's our new project for the 2006 season. It's a suspended looping coaster from Vekoma in Holland. And what makes it different is on a suspended coaster, you hang underneath the track, which is a totally different ride experience. It's actually a very, very exciting ride experience. This is one of my personal favourite rides, and I'm thrilled that we've bought one. And it's got lots of new features, like a boomerang, which will be over in the distance over there. And this is the highest point. So the coaster comes in, it's just a standard pull-up coaster. It's not a launch mechanism coaster like the coaster we put in last year. And shoots you off on a fantastic journey, which goes way over in that direction and swoops down over our railway track and basically is a fabulous new ride. It's named after our male lion, who's the head of our pride, Kumali, and it's an African theme. So when it's finished, you'll see lots of African detailing. There'll be lots of thatched roofs and sort of carved African icons. And over there, near that big yellow crane, we'll have a big cave entrance to the ride, which is the sort of the themed magical entrance that you walk through. And it'll look completely different come the spring and opening for the Easter season.
Over in the zoo, the lions have been confined to indoor quarters for some days, while workmen carry out repairs to a section of the water ride, which passes through their outdoor enclosure.
What's this, eh?
My name's Dennis Piercy, and I look after big cats. We've got mother, two cubs, and an unrelated male. And we're hoping to breed from them shortly. We brought them in from Longleat just over a year ago. Good girls, Azzy. All into a new enclosure, so we just got settled in nicely. The lions have been inside now for about 10 days. They're just repairing the water ride, filling the ride up with water and testing it. And then after the water ride's all sorted, we can let them out and they'll be out all summer. We've got a very good relationship. We try to work with them as much as possible. We play with them with a brush, and so if we've got any problems, we bring a vet in to have a look at them. There's no stress, it's all stress-free. We do a little bit of training with them before we feed them. Come on, girls. Come on. Come on, babies. This is a scented stick, and we get them to touch that with the nose, and then we put a little piece of meat on here, and we feed them for being good. If they don't do it, we don't feed them at that time. But they all get fed later on in the day. Look what we've got for you. Come on. Up. We can put them up in the air. Just have a look. Check the pads, the feet. Good girl. See if there's any lumps and bumps, any scratches. Check the claws. Have a look in their mouth. Check the teeth. And it's just a quick visual check.
Later, with the water ride fixed, Kumali gets a chance to do a bit of visual checking himself of the new roller coaster named after him.
Kumali is just over 3 years old. He's a bit immature yet. He's just like a teenager. He's a bit silly. Once he gets another year on him, we should be able to breed through all three cats, and we'll be unrelated for a while.
So they're the only notes at the minute, then.
Who's ever used?
They're the ones that's going to sing and dance.
It's audition time, and in less than 3 months, some of these performers will be taking centre stage in Flamingoland shows, including the Professor Bubbles children's show.
All right,
then, everybody up. This is Circle of Life. I'll do it with you, then we're going to go in groups of four, all right?
My name is Hayley Richardson. I'm a choreographer, and I've been hired by Flamingo Land to put together three evening production shows and concentrate mainly on the daytime show, which is Professor Bubbles.
Ball to inch turn, step across, kick. Drag turn.
This is my first big production show that I'm going to be putting together. Really looking forward to it. I've worked at Flamingo Land before, but as a dancer, and this is the first time I've been given an opportunity to put together my own shows.
Preparation.
Today we are holding auditions for the dancers and the production singers, and tomorrow the same. We have about 80 people coming each day.
Well done, next group.
It takes a certain type of someone to work at Flamingo Land, I think. They have to have a certain type of personality. Young and enthusiastic is mainly what I'm looking for. Obviously a strong dancer, a good singer.
Thanks. I like her a lot. I just hope she can sing.
One part of Flamingo Land not on show to the public is the staff accommodation. This flat is known to its residents as the penthouse. This season it's home to Hungarian economics graduate Gabor Kellerman.
This is my third season in Flamingo Land. After I graduated, I came back and last summer again to work in here as a catering supervisor. I've been promoted in last season because first time when I came in here, I was a catering assistant.
Welcome back. How are you?
I'm brilliant. How are you?
Good. Very well.
Personnel manager Nikki Riddell is responsible for the welfare of the park's 300 staff.
Yeah, just in time for coffee.
Thank
you. Historically, we had an ongoing problem with lack of staff, particularly working on catering, and it was a gap that we needed to fill, and we had a problem that we needed to solve. And when the EU opened up in 2004, we were inundated with requests from youngsters who were hospitality experts wanting to come to the UK for the summer initially, just to improve their language skills and work in a completely different environment, but something that they were familiar with. Hence, the majority of the staff that we have at the moment work on the catering. They're all so happy to be here and given the opportunity to work in the UK that I think it's so far been a win-win situation for everybody. Has Darren spoken to you about what you're going to be doing this year? Did you mention that before you left last year, that'd be extra responsibilities this year?
Yeah, you know, I was supervisor of Jolly Sarah restaurant. Last year, I will be supervisor of Jolly Sarah, plus I have to look after the old fish and chip shop, what can be found in the park. It's a good experience for me, a challenge. I want to improve my language skills, that's the most important. I want to speak as good as I can.
It will be hearing me Jolly in this season, so loads of work to do.
The first season, 2004, we took a gamble because obviously we didn't know if it was going to work or not, how the English staff would relate to the European staff, what their English skills would be like. So we took a bit of a gamble and just decided that we would employ 20. So 20 out of 300 would be a starting post just to see how it progressed. And 20 became 40 because they all wanted to bring a friend over because they enjoyed it so much. This year we will look to between 70 and 80 again out of 300. So a good proportion of the staff, but again we've got enough positions for everybody local who wants to come and join us. Good to see you again.
You all as right. Well. Bye. See you later.
Let's pop the right leg.
Meanwhile, back at the auditions in the American bar.
The standard's been quite good. I don't think I've got together the full team yet, but we've still got another day of auditioning, so I'm confident that we'll get what we want in the end. The Professor Bubble Show is going to be totally different this year. It's going to have live interaction with the audience, whereby in the past it's all been done in studio, so it's all on tape. And I'm adding another character into the Professor Bubble show. And I won't say any more.
Number 9, 12, 8, 3, and 4. Unfortunately, we don't need you as a dancer, but if you want to stay and sing, then you can.
After the break, they're all of a flutter over plans for the new bird show. Angerball gets to grips with promotion, but he still has to clean the deep fat fryer.
Well, you want them sure, don't you?
Yeah.
You want them just to be... Do you want the pleat left in there?
Back at home in the northeast, Hayley Richardson, who's in charge of entertainment at Flamingo Land for the new season, has got her mum Carol and a friend making the costumes for the Professor Bubbles children's show.
What are you wearing on your legs for this?
Just fishnets. And heels, and we've got the glasses on, you know, the little...
Oh, yeah.
Sorry. That looks all right there, but once if I take them anymore, well, they're not going to be able to dance, are they?
Well, that's why I've left them big.
Right. Does it look all right?
Looks good.
Yeah.
Hard to tell whether he's in dress.
I don't know about the slippers.
Yeah, the slippers.
I don't know about the slippers. Oh, yes, very sophisticated. Yeah.
Oh,
yes, very good. Have a look in the mirror, see what
it looks
like.
Lovely.
There's a costume to make for Hayley's new character in the show, Professor Troubles. He's Professor Bubbles' multicoloured nephew.
So the nephew's going to be exactly the same as that, but without the wrinkles and the grey hair. But you need to make a cap. If we've got enough material out of that, just go around his head and then the peak here.
It's going to take a tiny bit of material for that one, though.
Quite a big head.
It's just like foam, you know, like a spongy.
It smells. I bet it's hot in there though, don't
it? I bet it do.
Victoria Gibb, who's married to Flamingoland's boss, Gordon Gibb, is a theme designer and she played a big part in the redesign of their home.
The last time you were here was probably about 2 years ago when we'd just moved in. And we had great plans for what we were going to do with the house. To be honest, there's not much of the original house left inside. We've kind of stripped it down and rebuilt it. This is the kitchen. It's meant to look old. It's a 300-year-old lodge we're living in. So I didn't want anything to look too modern or too sort of shiny and sparkly. This room was supposed to be Gordon's gym. So we've got a hot tub put in just outside the French windows. And I came home one day and there was wonderful light in the room. It's west facing and I just loved it, so unfortunately he lost it and I gained it. But we are going to build him a gym next year in the outhouses.
The couple are expecting the arrival of their first baby any day now.
This is the nursery. The baby won't be in here at first anyway for the first 3 months, hopefully. He'll be sleeping in this with us in the bedroom. Well, that's Gordon permitting. We have to make sure that Gordon's happy with that too. I'm a little bit superstitious, so I haven't unpacked everything that we've bought him. There's lots of things that are still wrapped up because even though they've told me I'm having a boy, it just might not be a boy. And then I can whip these back to the shop and change them for the pink version when we do find out what it is. I've been very lucky. He's a very spoilt baby already. These are from my godson, Bede, who's just a year old. So these are all his clothes. So we've got plenty of everything. It's very strange to think of all these clothes actually fitting a little human being, but I guess that's what's going to happen really soon. It's quite terrifying, really. I don't intend to take much time off work, but I'm very lucky because not only do I work in an environment where I'm surrounded by people who will help, not least of all my mother-in-law lives on site and my sister-in-law also works, Melanie works there too, but there's any number of other people who will help me. But also I've got a great big office where I can have like part of a nursery and I'm my own boss, which means that I can do my work around my baby. I don't intend to let him suffer in any way, but by the same token, I don't think it'll do him any harm being with me at the office rather than being with me at home. But that might all change. I mean, you know, I might take one look at him and decide that I never want to set foot in an office for the next 6 months and I just want to lie down and stare at my newborn baby. You know, I don't know how I'm going to be. At the moment, the intention is to go straight back to work. Besides, they need me.
Back at Flamingo Land, Hungarian economics graduate Gabor is taking his new responsibilities as a catering supervisor very seriously.
We are in a minute in a Americanos. It sells fish and chips, sausages, burger, hot dogs, wraps, and it's open in the night time during the season, because next to us the American bar, and the people's coming out from American bar and everybody hungry, so wants fish and chips, especially at 12 o'clock. You can see already the difference between them two, so...
Have we got the hot dog for Saturday night, Gabor?
Yeah. Last year, I was supervisor in a Jolly Sailor restaurant, yeah? Was selling, like, one side in a kiosk, he's selling fish and chips and sausages, like, in here. This year, I've got one more, like, bigger than this one, fish and chip shop. It's called Frankie's Fish. So that's what I will do in this season, probably. That's the plan, and we'll see. That's the trick. If you put some D2 on there, it's like glue, and it looks better.
You've got the D2, mate.
A lot more responsibility, because just the Jolly Sailor is the busiest unit in the park, and that is sell very well as well, Frankie's as well, so take loads of money, and obviously bigger responsibility as well, so we'll see.
Gabor isn't the only one with a heavier workload this year. There are big plans to upgrade Flamingo Land's bird show.
My name's Peter Bloom, and I run the animal and bird shows at Flamingo Land, and I have done so for the last 22 years. We're going to get our African pie crow out. He's going to show you what we've been working on. This is so far two to three weeks' work. He's going to come out, he's going to pick a cloth up from the floor, put it in the bin, and go back for his titbit and then back into his box. So we've got a nice little triangle of work. It's how we do these things, and Sam will run him through.
Okay. I'm going to pass the cloth first, so we'll make it quite easy for her. Okay, Jess. Good, hey? Good girl. Good girl.
The last sort of 7 or 8 years have been strictly parrots, macaws, and you can hear them all in the background. But this year, they've decided to upgrade the show into a mixed show, and we have a new stadium in construction, and we've brought in a lot of new birds, different varieties, so we can make the show more interesting, more diverse, and more educational.
Now the trick is here getting one out at a time, because they all want to come and play. Okay.
When they're all out.
When they're all flying around and they're hungry, it's like being attacked by a herd of butterflies. You know. They're all over the place. Show's going to be different simply because of the variety of birds that we're going to have performing during the display. We keep some of the parrots, but we have seremas, we have crows, we have birds of prey, owls, Harris hawks, we've got a vulture. And all of these things we're going to bring out and try and explain what they are, why they're doing particular things in the show. I'm trying to relate that to, you know, sort of natural wild behaviour.
Up in the northeast, Hayley is preparing to head to Yorkshire to start rehearsals for the Professor Bubble Show.
Today I'm leaving my home in Newcastle. It's a very sad day, but excited at the same time. It's going to be good. But as you can see, the room's a bit jam-packed today because... well, it has been all Christmas, so I've been at home over the Christmas, so... And then when I move back home, I've got to put everything in this little room. So I'm happy to get everything out again. Splashed out on Saturday on a new mini convertible, and it's so lovely. Brand new, drove it out the showroom on Saturday. But it's cream, which isn't ideal for Flamingo Land. Convertible, which isn't ideal for Flamingo Land, but hopefully will be in the summer. But it's so lovely.
everything.
Well, I'll be back soon anyway, so. And you'll be coming, won't you?
Yes, we'll be down soon. Just drive carefully.
I will.
Love you.
Love
Remember
you.
The speed limits.
I will.
Drive carefully, okay?
I will.
Come on.
Love you. Love you too. See you soon.
Ring us when you get there.
You can be ringing about now and see how you're getting on.
Yes. Bye.
See you, bye.
And we'll be meeting Hayley again next time. Here's our competition again. Welcome to the show that takes you behind the scenes at Flamingoland Theme Park and Zoo in North Yorkshire during the countdown to opening for the 2006 summer season. And stay tuned for the chance to win a family break in York later in the programme. The park opens in just 2 months and choreographer Hayley Richardson is arriving to start rehearsals for the Professor Bubbles show. No staff accommodation is available for her yet, and she's been told she can stay in a luxury holiday caravan for now.
Ooh. Right. Nice, eh?
Caravans like this are normally reserved for guests, not staff.
This won't be where I'm staying, though. I know it isn't, because this is a high ethnic van. They're going to put us in a shed after all. But it's nice. We'll fight for this caravan now. Two of the smallest beds you've ever seen. I won't fit in there. That's better. Ooh. This is nice. This is obviously the main bedroom. I like this one. Oh, toilet. God, it's so small. And it's really freezing. It's like icy cold. We need some heating. You can't even hear any gas coming out.
Good job, what the duvet.
No! Brilliant. There's no electric either. And there's no water. Excellent. All right, thanks. Bye, bye, bye. He said it'll be sorted by the end of the day. He's going to get someone onto it straight away. And he said, if I play my cards right, then I can stay here.
Hayley's not the only one moving into a new home. Over in the zoo, the Mangabey family have got the removal men in too, in the shape of keepers, Dean and Tom.
Hello. It took a while to get them to move, and there was a bit of fuss, but... you know, it's better than knocking them out or anything like that, so we've got them and they can go down and have a look at their new house, see what they think. Well, the Mangabeys here at Flamingoland are part of a European Endangered Species Programme, and they're actually from West Africa. There's various species there that are really endangered. Just got a few of their toys as well to make it more homely for them.
I know it sounds a bit daft, but they're used to having the TV. I'm just wondering if that'll set them down a bit.
I don't think there's a plug socket actually for it.
Yeah, not at all.
We can soon get one. That's get one ribbed up though.
Yeah, we can sort it later.
We'll bring it down later.
You can still have your morning TV, guys. But only for a bit.
Well, the morning TV was just there to entertain them because they've been in a temporary sort of house there. They've not had access to an outdoor cage for a few months, so we put a TV on them, and we do that for a lot of the primates. The chimps love TV as well, so any old TVs that get thrown away, they come down the zoo and the monkeys watch them. There's no reason why we can't bring a TV down here as well, but they've got all this wonderful area, so there's probably enough to keep them occupied, but, you know, we'll give them a TV if they want one.
Are you all set?
Ready? Yeah, I'm through. We only actually got our breeding female 6 years ago, and this is actually one of the 10 rarest primates on the planet, and there's only actually 50 in Europe and very few in the wild, so it's a really important species that we're working on. It took us 5 years from getting her to actually get a live baby off her. So we, it's quite an achievement. She always had miscarriages and stillbirths and things like that. So this is sort of the end result of a lot of work, and we've got this now smashing new house for them that they're going to love. They look lost in it, actually. They look tiny in it, so it's really exciting for us, and we're pleased to get them down here.
Flamingo Land's farm area is being completely revamped for 2006. It's the pet project of theme designer Victoria Gibb, who's also the boss's wife.
Well, this is going to be Muddy Duck Farm. It's a new development for children. Obviously, the centre of the ride is these tractors, which are beautiful and almost full size, which is so exciting for children. We've got Muddy Duck Pond, which is obviously why we're called Muddy Duck Farm. And there'll be a beautiful duck house in the middle of there, and some hopefully quite muddy ducks happily sploshing away in the water in there. Over here, we're going to have sheep. We've got lambs and things happening, which will be quite exciting. We've got donkeys, shire horses, we've got Shetland ponies, we've got Dexters, which are the smallest cows. They're from Ireland and they're lovely. And they're going to be in that paddock over there, hopefully not too smelly. We're redeveloping all of the buildings that were in the old farm area, and it's all going to look, well, hopefully it's going to look like a cross between the farmhouse in Babe and something out of an Enid Blyton novel, but that's just wishful thinking. But the idea is that there's lots to see but nothing to touch. People just need to see the animals. They don't need to be touching them. For the animals' sake as well as the human beings, I don't think it's good policy.
Victoria's responsible for the themes and concepts behind all Flamingoland's rides. Her favourite bit of this new one hasn't been built yet.
We've also introduced some animatronics this year. We've got a fabulous pig and her suckling litter. And you go into a building and you just look down and see the pig and her litter all suckling away, and that's an animatronic. I think all in all it'll be a really fun ride.
Back in the holiday village, Hayley's busy settling into her temporary new home.
This is a hint, isn't it, that there's not going to be any heating with all these duvets. It's nice. One, two. Four. Six duvets! I'm going to have to put one of them duvets on the bottom because it's so cold. And if I just put a sheet there, I might freeze. Lovely. Oh, God. Wow. More blankets. We'll need them tonight. It's really cold.
Elsewhere in the holiday village, Melissa and Abby are busy preparing Flamingoland's log cabin guest accommodation.
Oh, this is one of 13 log cabins, which is a new phase for Flamingoland, although in its second year. The first season as an introductory was absolutely fantastic. When you start a new venture, you're never sure how it's going to go. And it was far better than we ever anticipated. They never stood empty, they were fully booked all through the year. And people who arrived to stay in our caravans were asking if there was vacancy so they could upgrade while on holiday to stay in a log cabin. They are aimed at the top end of our market, fully central heated, which is different to the caravans, and therefore at this time of year makes it far nicer to work in, because unlike the caravans, which are freezing, these are nice and warm.
Mind you, if you want luxuries like central heating, it doesn't come cheap at Flamingoland. A cabin like this costs over £1,200 a week in peak season.
Some people might say that £1,250 is an awful lot of money.
Yeah, and in some cases they might be right. However, I feel that the £1,250 is a very good price when, especially if you're mum and dad with four children, the price you pay, everything is included. So when you get here, you've not got your children at your ankles wanting this, that and the other, because you just take them into your theme park. You've got your ride starting for your toddlers from your very small up to your White Knuckle Valley and the new ride this year, as well as the zoo for a nice leisurely walk around and your leisure facilities. So everything you need for your week for your family is already here at no extra cost.
This is my first season doing the cabins. Last year I was based mainly on the caravans, so it's a real nice change to be on the cabins this year, especially since they're so much warmer than the caravans themselves. And to be honest with you, this is probably the worst job about doing them, because if you see, you've only got a certain amount of places that the hooks can go. So it's a case of trying to get the tension right throughout the pelmet, which you can see hasn't really worked here. And then hopefully hooking them up properly. And when you know you've gone wrong, it's a case of pulling them all down and starting them up again.
Over in the new Mangaby house, the family seem very happy with their new home.
We've just given them the one small enclosure today, but tomorrow we'll probably give them their large enclosure and just see how they get on, really. You know, get them into a good routine and see how it goes. They're settling in really, really well. We're really surprised. They just seem to have taken it all in their stride. You know, obviously, they've been through an ordeal of being moved and into a new house, but they're so chilled out. It's absolutely brilliant to watch them.
After the break, we'll be meeting Victoria's husband, and he's cruising for a bruising, and how to persuade a hippo he needs to see. There's been some wintry weather overnight at Flamingo Land, and there are worries it may have caused delays to work on the new £6 million roller coaster. But operations manager Phil Pritchard is bursting with confidence.
When the project first started, we allowed 2 weeks for this type of bad weather scenario. We've now got it. Hopefully it'll be clear by maybe tomorrow. As you can see, all the workers have turned in. We've got themed rock work in the lake. They're happy chappies. Some lads working on the disabled ramp exit to the ride. The ride at the moment's been commissioned by Vekoma, who manufactured the device. The installation team have finished 2 weeks ahead of schedule, which is fantastic news for us, and the commissioning team's now on site. They check every single item that's been installed, and then as soon as they're happy, we can run.
All right, Gordon, this is obviously our first session. We want to be doing a bit and see how
Park boss Gordon Gibbs taking boxing lessons. Probably just as well the countdown to opening is going smoothly.
Boxing's an amazing discipline, and the fitness is absolutely second to none. Even when I was playing rugby to a fairly high standard, I've never been as fit as I am now. It's a great distraction from the stresses and the strains of running a business.
That's all right, it's nice. My name's Craig Salt. I'm a coach at Westway Boxing Club in Scarborough. And I've come along today to do a bit with Gordon Gibb from Flamingo Land, and hopefully we're going to have a useful lad on our hands there.
1-2. Good lad, that's good.
There's no half measures in boxing. Good. It's a one-on-one sport, and you do need to be exceptionally fit. I personally think it's the hardest sport out.
1-2. Good, that's good, that's good. So have a look at that left hook. You want to do the left hook nice and loose from the nips. Whip it in from your backside.
Gordon's in good shape. And hopefully we're going to get a little bit more weight off him and get him a bit sharper.
Faster. Boom, boom. Boom, boom.
For a novice, I'm quite impressed. He's done very, very well. The pad work went quite well. I think he's got a decent prospect ahead of him. He'll just stay amateur. He's at that age. I think he's about 30-year-old now. After 35, you finish. You can't go any further. It's not like the pro games. You can put boxing pro games till you're 45, 50 if you want.
Time. So I'm very, very pleased. And you want to get some smaller pad gloves.
Yeah.
With plenty of padding in them. These are like sparring gloves, really.
Right.
They're all right. Get you some pads. Can you afford me? We might have a spare pair at gym.
I train in between the day and go back to work afterwards, and always feel that I've got clearer thought after training than I did before, so I don't really see any clash that way. With the home life, we'll have to wait and see, because obviously the real match of the day is coming up with the impending birth of my son, but I'd have to say I'm a little bit more nervous about going into that one than I am going into the ring with somebody.
Meanwhile, the expectant mum herself has taken up a more gentle sport to help her combat the stresses and strains of working whilst heavily pregnant.
Be good. I'll be half an hour. Don't bark at anyone. It's something I started doing about 4 months ago. I used to run up until I was 5 months pregnant, but it got very uncomfortable and I started getting horrible stitches and I frightened myself a bit, so I stopped doing that and started swimming. So I swim about half a mile, front crawl every day, and that does it. I think that's keeping me fit and healthy. I hope so anyway. It's a much more comfortable exercise to do when you're pregnant than running, let me tell you. We're expecting our first child in 2 weeks, exactly 2 weeks. It's something I've wanted for, well, ever, really. I'm really very much looking forward to it, and then at the same time, I'm completely terrified. I feel that every other job you do, you have to go to college and learn about, and this one, they just kind of hand you this wriggly little red baby and say, get on with it, which is, petrifying, really. But I'm sure we'll manage. We've got two dogs and three cats, and we're managing okay with them. This will just be like another one of the animals, I'm sure.
Back at the park, preparations are well underway for the public opening, and in the Plaza Bar, the stage set for the Professor Bubbles show is taking shape, and Hayley's made some dramatic changes to the production.
The show's different this year because I've introduced a new character, I've introduced a bit of magic, so I've got two illusions coming. Okay, Dave. Okay, this is going to be... It's been difficult, actually, because it's going to move, obviously, without you know, it's going to be a bit of magic. But we've been having problems thinking what I could be. So I think it's going to be... We've decided on a big vase of flowers, quite luminous flowers. And obviously it's going to move like this and the kids are going to shout. Hopefully. This is another thing. We've got a little pin in here. Dave, on the picture, do you think you pull the pin out? And when he's talking, this is going to be a portrait of Professor Bubbles and things are going wrong in his lab. And like that, the picture's going to fall and the kids are going to shout, ah! Hopefully. There's a plot as well. So there's a reason to watch it till the end. It's not just singing and dancing.
But she's worried about how the park's directors will react to her changes to a tried and tested formula.
There's only one person that knows about this new character, so obviously I'm very concerned in case they don't like it. I mean, they might not even like me bringing in a new character, but I think that that's what the show needs. It needs something new. I'm going ahead with it, but it's just such a risk. So just dreading the day of the directors coming to see it. I'm so worried in case they don't like it. But there's nothing not to like about it. It's going to be great.
Over in the zoo, head keeper Sam DeBell is also feeling anxious. 3-year-old hippo Ernie is facing a major operation.
Hello, Godzilla. Are you coming to say hello? You a good girl? Come here. Yeah. This is Godzilla. She's about 6 years old, and she's the soppiest one of the lot of them. We've got three hippos, two adult females, and one of those adult females when she came was pregnant, so now we've got a little baby as well. Betty is the mother, we've got Godzilla, which is the auntie, and we've got little baby Ernie. We don't really want him having baby Ernies with his mother or his auntie. So the idea is that we're going to try and lock him on his own in this area, which will be quite well bedded up, and he's going to be neutered. Which will stop any overbreeding problems. I'll get your dinner down, hang on. The procedure that the vets are going to carry out, it's quite unusual. I believe it hasn't been done for quite a few years.
Go and get your dinner.
As far as I know. We've got our vet coming, we've got a vet from London that's done one before.
Come on, Ernie.
And we've also got the International Zoo Group coming to do the anaesthetic, because that in itself is a huge risk.
Good boy, come on,
you're right. Good boy. You're going to have to get used to me. I'm sorry, but you are. Yes. Very good. Good boy. The bit I am personally worried about is A, getting him split off from his mum and his auntie, and B, how those two are going to react, because they're going to have to be locked outside completely away from him, because they'll get het up. I'm not particularly worried about bringing them back in because I think they'll be so glad to sort of make sure that he's all right. It shouldn't be a problem, but the bit in between from the first bit I'm quite worried about.
There are still problems with Hayley's accommodation. She's going to see personnel manager Nikki Riddell.
I left the caravan, I spent the night there, and then I had to move my stuff out. So instead of taking it all home, I moved them into the dressing room. This is the dressing room in the American bar, and this is all my stuff. And just waiting for somewhere else to live. So I'm commuting at the moment. Hi. Give me some good news, Nikki.
Right, so it's about your accommodation, yeah?
Uh-huh.
Right, what we need to do is initially, because we're in the winter period, we're going to need to put you into a flat, all right, with the other girls, uh-huh. Initially. As soon as the new accommodation's built, I'll actually move you into one of the superior rooms, which is actually built either for two people or a supervisor. None of the caravans have any facilities to them at the moment because we're still in our winter programme. So what we've needed to do with Hayley is move her into one of the staff flats.
I was staying in a hire van. They're the vans that people pay for during the summer, so I don't think they wanted me staying in there.
When you're ready, come round and get a key, mm-hmm. and then we can move you into any flat that's downstairs that's ready at the moment. Don't unpack fully, don't fully settle, and then as soon as the new flats are ready, I promise I'll move you into a nicer one that's built for a supervisor. How's that?
If you promise me.
I promise, no, I wouldn't say anything I don't mean.
Well, at least I know where I stand now.
Thank you. No problem.
And we'll be meeting the rest of the Professor Bubbles showcast next time. Welcome to the show that takes you behind the scenes at Flamingoland Theme Park and Zoo in North Yorkshire for all the thrills and spells and ups and downs of the countdown to opening for the 2006 summer season. And stay tuned for the chance to win a family break at Beamish in County Down later in the programme.
Please. Just have a feel at them. They're not too bad.
With less than 2 weeks to go until Flamingoland opens to the public, vital safety checks have begun on the park's new £6 million attraction, a roller coaster, Cormali.
And then open the gates, so they'll only come up here when they're locked.
Richard Barnes is a regular visitor to Flamingoland at this time of year. He's one of the UK's leading independent ride safety inspectors. Everything from the safety gates to the seat restraints must be checked and rechecked before he allows the new roller coaster to carry its first passenger.
This is the top one.
Yes. So it should do both. Our intention is to prove that all the safety control circuits are working correctly. And it's not just a matter of checking that they actually function in the first place. What we're really interested in, what happens if something goes wrong? For instance, if there's a sensor out on the track, we don't check that it's just working now. We actually fool it into misbehaving and see what happens to the train once that's happened. The main thrill you get from this is the fact that you're underslung, you're actually suspended from the track, so your feet are free, and it means that there's actually nothing beneath you when you're going around the track. I reckon this is the smoothest I've seen in a long time. I'm pretty confident about this one. Having heard it run and watched it run over the last few days, it's one of the quietest and sleekest coasters I've come across in a long time. And most of the tests have been already carried out by the manufacturer. So I think that we've got a pretty good chance of it working on the opening day.
I'm guessing we're going to have a lot of William sleeping.
Flamingoland boss Gordon Gibb and his wife Victoria have taken a couple of days off work after the birth of their son and heir.
Stuck in his face.
It's a bit graphic to do one of you breastfeeding. Is it?
Well, I don't know, but no. Well, this is William Fraser. It was an induced labour, which meant he came out when he wasn't particularly ready to. I think he was quite happy where he was.
There was no future staying where he was. He needed to crack on.
Well, I don't know. He could have been in there for another week or two, I think, quite happily swimming around, booting his mother.
It needed to be Flamingoland's first creation for 2006.
don't wobble him. It wasn't bad. You sort of forget everything that you've been through once you get him home and everything. Hey, fella. I was labouring overnight and I came out, gave birth at 6 o'clock in the morning and then came out at midday. So, well, it's just a very happy arrival in the Gibb household.
Did you hear that? It's the last time in your life you'll be applauded for burping.
Although tests on the Kamali coaster have been going well, there are problems with last year's new ride, Velocity. It's supposed to be the fastest in the UK, but it isn't going very fast now. In fact, it's got well and truly stuck during maintenance by its Dutch manufacturers. Operations manager Phil Pritchard wants to know what's happened.
Train stuck then. What went wrong?
I don't know.
Is there anybody here that saw it? Does anyone know what's wrong? No, we don't know what's wrong.
I don't know.
What time do you think it might be free? About 1 hour?
1 hour, I guess.
Yeah. And then hopefully run it again, see if it gets stuck again.
We'd virtually finished the commissioning work of the system last night. Everyone was happy, the train was running fine. Unfortunately, with all these rides, they're run by sophisticated computers. They did a brake test and the train got stuck. So 7 o'clock last night, I got the phone call, probably 7:30 last night. This morning we've got to recover it. 3 hours with a little chain block, trying to pull the train on top of that track section. They'll let it go about another hour and then it'll roll back into the station.
Flamingo Land Zoo and Bird Walk are open all year round. Unbeknownst to visitors, head keeper Steve Nazir has been busy planning for an emergency he hopes will never happen.
Bird flu obviously is high on the agenda at the moment for us. At the moment, it's gone as far as France. So we already have our biosecurity measures in place. Not only for the birds, but for the staff as well. We've got a nice collection of birds here. We've got quite a few important birds here as well, as far as endangered species, breeding programs, that sort of thing. And of course, by our name, we've got a large group of flamingos also. One of the major issues is the wildfowl, the wild ducks, the wild geese that come in. We can't prevent the wildfowl from coming in. With birds like the aviaries here, what we've got in place here is to be able to cover the rooftops. And maybe some of the sides as well, to prevent birds passing over and dropping faeces and so on, which is one of the major problems of the disease itself. We've got the general public, obviously, to to be aware of, but that will be governed by the government anyway, i.e. we'd probably close a certain part of the zoo down where the birds are. From a keeper point of view, we have protocol in place at the moment, so that we have things like foot baths, we have protective clothing and so on. We'll have designated names for designated areas so that we can isolate problems should any arise, The likelihood of it coming obviously is very real, with it being so close to us. France is not that far away respectively. So yes, it is a worry, but on the face of that, we are prepared for it. So we have been given a lot of information from the government regarding this issue. And we are aware of everything that we need to do now. So I feel a little bit more comfortable with that, but you can never be too sure.
You've got your fingers stuck up your nose, that's why.
New mum Victoria has come up with the perfect solution to juggling work and family. Her newborn son goes to work with her.
I know.
I think we managed a week at home before telephones started ringing all the time for things that were being built on site. People just wanting to know this little detail or that little detail, and I couldn't answer them from where I was. And he's such a good baby, aren't you?
I decided it was safe enough to come back to work with him. I've learnt the technique of discreet breastfeeding, which is essential when you're in an office full of people. And he's just been brilliant. I mean, he goes for a walk every day in the zoo and sees all the animals and, you know, very lucky little boy to be brought up looking at giraffes and hippos and rhinos all the time. And he's no bother. I'm getting all my work done because people on site are getting questions answered when they need them answered, which makes me happy. And because I'm such a control freak, I'm getting things built that I need, building the way I want them built. And most busiest time of year, you know, this is when I need to be looking at stuff. And he's just no bother. He just comes in, feeds and sleeps. I'm probably operating on about 50% efficiency at the moment, but I don't want to not give him any time he needs because it's precious moments and they grow up really quickly, so. He needs to shush, doesn't he, Molly? Hey?
It looks good, but needs cleaning up. So if you make sure always that you're behind them two things there.
And then Bubbles, good, good, must get to work now. So much to do, so little
Over
time.
In the Plaza Bar, rehearsals for the Professor Bubbles children's show are underway.
I'm here! Hi, kids! I'm Chubbles and I'm cool!
And then it goes into it because I'm cool.
Is it
Love the way that is. Do you know what I mean? Lovely.
Right, positions for Hero.
Hayley Richardson has produced and choreographed the show. Park bosses still don't know about the new character she's introduced.
5, 6, 7, and wait, up, 2, 3, 4, down, 10. All right, then you've got 1, 2.
I've had this week, the girls arrived, we've had the recording studio this week, so I've spent all week doing choreography really, and this is my first full day rehearsal.
That's a flick.
It's going well, the girls are just fantastic, so it's going well.
Gonna be there, you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, there, hip. All right? Yeah. James, I'll just do it once more for you, okay?
One more time, if there's any more false hand movements.
From the top, 5, 6, 7, and a step, releve, step, releve, step, over, step, turn,
Perfect. Loved it. You're all coming through to London, well done.
I'm ready, come on, let's go. We better push the button and then we'll know. We'll never get a chance if we'll stay so. We're gonna push it now, cause I stay so.
After the break, how's Ernie the Hippo doing after his big operation last week? And the Professor Bubbles show hits a technical hitch.
Whoa, there's another screw in there, you know.
Yeah, I know, but I have to miss them.
The cast of the Professor Bubbles children's show have to be multi-talented. Not only must they be able to sing and dance, but they have to be good at DIY set building too.
If you can hold it for me, I'm going to sort of try and drill through each side.
So we've actually been doing this illusion without these screws in?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Whoa. There's another screw in there, you know.
Yeah, I know, but I have to miss them.
But I think you've hit it.
Yeah, I've hit the other screw.
Yep, that's what I said.
Have you got it?
Yeah. That's another screw. That's another screw.
No, it's not.
It really is.
We can...
I can smell metal burning as we speak.
Right, last screw of the day.
Careful.
Okay, I'm hitting another screw. This is really not good.
Men.
There we go.
Let go, Shannon.
Oh, look at that. Sturdy as a house.
Look at this.
I think we should get someone.
I think we'll get a mechanic in. Yeah. That's lovely, James. Thanks for that.
I think
it's
that
nice to have a man on the team, isn't it?
But Hayley's very proud of the new special effects she's introduced in the show.
This is the invention that Professor Bubbles has made. And his young nephew's a bit naughty and he wants to go in. So basically he goes in, no one knows it's a shrinking machine. He goes in, basically, obviously he's big. We close the door. We sing Push the Button during the song. Gets wheeled over here. This happens very quickly, but I'll show you slowly. Anyway, so he's gone in. And this all happens very quickly. And then we wheel it back off. We're still singing and looking nice. we open it and he shrank. And then we pick him up and he talks and things, but this is the shrinking Professor Troubles. So the audience get to see him briefly when he's in the box just to show something's happened. Because he talks like this. But then we shut the door again and then the big one gets back in. Scary, eh?
Over in the zoo, the new bird show arena is almost ready and Sam Marshall's about to try it out for the first time.
Okay, I'm going to get Derek out. He's my hooded vulture. Now, before I start, I'm going to say I'm a little bit nervous because he hasn't been out here before and you never know how a bird's going to react to something new. So hopefully he's going to work well. I've only got half an hour. The guys building this place are on their lunch break, so I'm rushing in here quickly. Calla, can I have Derek? Well done. Hello, chicken. This is Derek. Now, he's never seen people before apart from me either, so I'm not sure how he'll react to you. I want him to follow me from point to point so we get an idea of how big this bird is. Well done. Come on, up you come. Jump, jump. It's also quite windy in here, so I think he's having trouble flying from point to point because you can see by the size, I mean, he's a big bird and he has a little bit of trouble with the wind. And his aim's not very good today. So we're going to have him flying about in the show, but also get him running as well. Because he looks really funny when he runs. Come on. There we go, Derek. Good boy. Good lad. One more. Good boy. And we'll put him back away. And he has to go back through this tunnel, which is also new. You come down here. Now, do you see where he's supposed to go? Yeah? In there. I try and form a bond with my birds, because when you have them out here, you've got absolutely no control over what's going to happen. And if they fly off or get frightened, you want them to come back to you because you're the safe person to be with. But birds of prey are completely different because they don't bond to you that way. It's a whole different way of training and it's a whole different way of working with them. So they're slightly harder in that respect than things like crows. But crows are just, you just get reward from them. Parrots are the same. They bond very closely to their trainer. And if you're kind to them, then you can get so much out of them. So that's probably my favourite part of the job is the bonding bit. Quite often when you bring a bird into a new place for the first time, they get really afraid, which is fair enough. It's all very new, and I expect a certain amount of mess-ups. But that was pretty much perfect by the book, so I'm actually feeling a lot better than I did half an hour ago.
Victoria Gibb, the boss's wife, isn't entirely happy with the way some of her theme design work on the new roller coaster has been interpreted, so she's off down to the site in the pouring rain.
Look, civilization, we've got proper concrete now. So most of the walkway of the ride, entrance and exit, is all themed concrete with these big fence posts either side. The reason the fence is so high here is because it's a dangerous area and we don't want people to be able to get out into the ride area. Only half my columns have been painted with these stripes around them, which looks a little bit odd. But the weather has been so awful that the painter can't get up on the man lift to do the painting. In fact, I think he might have gone home. Andrew, I'm down at the Kamali site and there's no themed painting being done. Is he around that he could pop down and meet me?
Oh, give me a ring now. Hang on there, Vicky. Yeah, I can't get hold of him on his phone. I'll have to leave it.
Right, if you see him, Andrew, will you tell him I've got this drawing for him and I want to talk to him about it before he leaves?
I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. This is the offending column. Well, there are 8 of them altogether. Anyway, this is what I want, and this is what they've done. And it was a good guess. I don't like the colours for a start. That blue's horrible. And it's just sort of too rough looking. It needs to be more like my drawing, I think. That would be the best idea.
Last week, Ernie, the 3-year-old hippo, had a major operation to prevent him breeding with his mother and aunt. His keeper, Sam, has been keeping a close eye on him.
Ernie's doing very well. He had his operation on Friday. It's now Tuesday. Friday night, there was staff with him all the way up until 2 o'clock in the morning. He was round pretty much from his anaesthetic by 9 at night, standing up and able to walk. he was a little bit swollen and obviously very sore because it was a very intrusive operation. I mean, this tissue that they had to go through was quite horrific, really, to see a vet up to his elbow in hippo. But no, he's, I mean, as you can see at the moment, he's been very well. He's on antibiotics and painkillers every day, which we're just mixing up in bits of food and trying to get him to eat it rather than his greedy anti-Godzilla. As you can see, there's no water in the pool at the moment. That's mainly to make sure that his wounds heal before he goes anywhere near any water. We let him back with his mum and his auntie on Saturday morning. They're all very pleased to see each other again. And they slept together on Friday night on either side, but he was separate on his own. And yeah, it was like, oh well, what's next sort of thing. So they've done really well. We're really pleased with them. Hello. Godzilla's very camera shy. Can't help but you. Is he hello? Yes. Every day we hose them down about two or three times a day just to keep them moist. It's quite dry and warm-ish in here. And by just keeping them damp like that, it gives them something to look forward to. They have got a bowl of water to drink, but they'd rather drink it off the floor after we've hosed them down. But it's been a brilliant experience for everyone that was involved. And as far as I believe and remember, he's only the first one in Europe and the second one in the world to survive an anaesthetic. So we're really chuffed.
There's trouble with Professor Bubbles. He's flat on his back.
Just after you left this morning, unfortunately James hurt his back. So we're going to go and have a word with him, see how he is. He seemed to be in a lot of pain. He was crying. He was bent over. I think James is Professor Bubbles, and he was painting the inside of the shrinking machine. We all went for lunch and left him in the room, and he's not very well. How are you feeling?
The pain's going away a little bit, but my back's just like really tight, and it just keeps like making really bad shooting pains up my back. But it could be a trapped nerve, could be.
I think it sounds like a trapped nerve to be that severe quickly.
Yeah, it just felt a twang when I bent down.
Did you?
I was like, I can't move, so they had to get me on a chair and stuff. I suppose, you know, the worst thing about it is I'm gonna have to get all you girls to give me massages, I think, so.
I'm sure they won't mind.
No.
I can take you to the doctors if you want to go. What do you think?
At the moment, it's just resting. I feel okay at the moment, but if it does play up, I'll let you know straight away and you can take me down to Moulton.
Well, the best thing to do today is just to stay in bed, I think.
So no breakdancing today, then?
Unfortunately not. But it's a good job, you know, with being Professor Bubbles, he's bent over anyway, isn't he? So he's got a bit of back trouble anyway.
Well, you know, I did this for my art. I didn't. But if it does come back...
Let me know.
I'll let you know, yeah.
Okay.
Thanks for coming down and seeing me and that.
Okay, we're all worried about you. Keep me informed, though, yeah?
I need back massages. Get them on a rotor system.
I'll see what I can do.
I think I need 4 a day.
Okay. It's not a lot to ask, James. I'll ask them. All right, then. I'll come back. Well,
all right, then.
I'll be back in a couple hours.
All right, then.
But stay here. Don't move.
Okay, I'll see you in a bit.
Bye.
Bye.
And we'll be bringing you an update on James's back next. Welcome to the show that takes you behind the scenes at Flamingo Land Theme Park and Zoo in North Yorkshire during the countdown to opening for the 2006 summer season. And stay tuned for the chance to win a family break in Northumberland later in the programme. It's just 3 days till the park opens to the public, and there's still a lot to do. The new attraction, a £6 million roller coaster called Kumali, is being put through one final crucial test before it's allowed to carry passengers for the first time.
Well, this is one of the final checks that we have to do, and it's to check that the people's legs who are dangling underneath the train don't hit any of the theming that's been put up over the last couple of weeks. And to do that, they fitted a large plywood structure right on the front of the train. which is the actual distance away from the train that the people might reach if they're the longest people that go on the ride. And we're going to run that round and just hope that it gets around. Fine, it was well clear. Well, that's good news. Because my big worry with this, doing this test, is so close to opening, is the remedy, if it doesn't get round, can put us back by a day, so that's pretty good news.
Right, girls, are you ready? Come in then.
Over in the Plaza Bar, the cast of the Professor Bubbles children's show are busy trying on the costumes made by producer Hayley's mum, Carol.
What do I look like? Do I look sick?
Are you happy with the length of them?
Yes. I think Mel's looks a bit short.
Is this the one that was dropped in the mud?
Yes.
Have you not washed it yet?
I thought you were washing it.
How can I wash it at home when you have it here?
Well, I don't think that's very true.
Unless you want me to take it home now and
I
bring
it back.
I think
you'll have to take it home.
Because you'll be washing them every week, won't you?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Every week.
Naturally.
Yeah. That's all right then.
In the Jolly Sailor, one of Flamingo Land's busiest restaurants, staff are busy putting the finishing touches.
I'm Tom. I've been here, it's my third year now. In a few days' time, all 200 seats in this restaurant are going to be full. Put some vinegar in hot water here. Gives it a nice shine when you polish it. The restaurant itself is like an Italian style restaurant, pizzas, pastas, salad. In high season you can expect to probably fill it about four times over during the lunchtime. That's a bit we all look forward to.
You like my hat anyway?
In the kitchen, Gabor's trying out some new dishes. He's not a professional chef, he's an economics graduate from Hungary.
I've tried to do a salad. A special salad. It's not on the menu, but we just try to figure out now. And it will be on a special board, hopefully, if everybody likes it. So I try to preparing that now. All right, firstly, the lettuce. Chop some tomato.
Flamingo Land Marketing Director Melanie Wood, the boss's sister, is working from home today.
It's very, very difficult to juggle family life and work life. I've got a very, very good nanny who helps out tremendously. But it's nice that I have the choice to go to work or actually work from home. Working from home is actually far more productive than going into work sometimes because you get pulled every which way. So when I'm at home, it's a far more relaxed, far more productive atmosphere, to be honest. I don't get an enormous amount of leisure time because the children are so young. We're very fortunate. Last year we built an indoor swimming pool. So we're now able to, once the children are asleep, have a few laps of the swimming pool and a bit of a relax in the jacuzzi. So that's probably what we look forward to at the end of a hard day. My job this year is particularly demanding. I will be making a new 10-second commercial. That's not something I do every year, basically because it's so costly. It's a very high percentage of my annual marketing budget. It's going to cost us in the region of £30,000, and that is just for a 10-second advert. It's vital that I don't make any mistakes in the filming, in the editing, choosing what rides we're going to put. It's so important that we get the right mix straight away because it's a lot of money for me to waste.
Meanwhile, back in the kitchen at the Jolly Sailor,
do you like cooking,
Gabor? Yeah, I like it. This is my hobby, actually, one of my hobbies. That's a bit strange. I'm working here, and my real job is like an economist, so I should be in a bank or in a stock or something like that, but maybe later on. I feel too young myself to working behind the computer and typing on a computer things. So at the minute, I'm trying to put in a tuna in a salad. After it will be going some sweet corn on and lemon. That's my idea for the new salad, but think it looks all right. But I think we need to ask somebody else as well.
Yeah, well, mate.
Look at that. I tried some new things.
Beautiful.
There's a salad going out with baguette, like usually, but this is a new type of salad. It's called, like, tuna and sweet corn.
We'll just set up this table.
All right. Salad, eating salad stuff.
But I'll admit, very, very nice.
Honestly?
Yeah. Makes a change.
Yeah. But I know I'm good, so...
Go back to your kitchen.
He probably doesn't like the ground too firm.
Melanie, the marketing director, has taken the afternoon off work to go with her husband Tim to visit their racehorse Max, who's in training with John Quinn at his yard in North Yorkshire.
And as we said,
my husband struggled very much with deciding on what to buy me for birthdays and Christmas, and about three Christmases ago he thought it was something that was a bit different, and indeed it was. He bought Max as a surprise Christmas present for me, which was lovely, very, very nice, and to be honest I never guessed for a minute what it was, which is unusual because I usually do guess.
Yeah, need a good start.
Absolutely, because we know he doesn't like the ground too fast. Right. Like last summer, Timothy, when we ran him at York.
So is Maxie at the front?
Max is in front.
Let's hope he stays like that for the rest of the season.
Come on, Maxie.
In our leisure time, when we do get it, we like to go to the races. We have three racehorses now. Two not very successful ones that we don't talk about, but one moderately successful horse that my husband and son especially go out and watch train at the weekend.
You can tell the horses who are more forward, they're getting up there easily.
Yeah,
easily,
funny,
easily.
If Max
easily.
Was running locally, we would go and watch him and cheer him on and hopefully celebrate in his win, which he hasn't had too many of, but, you know, he's doing okay.
So let's hope he can be winning again this year.
Absolutely.
And I feel he will.
Backstage at the Plaza Bar, the cast of the Professor Bubbles show are preparing for a special preview in front of the park's bosses.
I was making
silly mistakes when I was nervous.
Yeah.
Don't tell me that, Mel.
Me and Donna were talking yesterday about how we blank. Like when you just stand there and you go, oh yeah, start dancing again. Yeah, but it won't happen, Hayley, honestly.
Please don't flang.
Fortunately, the star of the show, James, who plays Professor Bubbles, has recovered from his back trouble.
Okay then. It's really strange having a wide body, isn't it?
But Hayley's worried about what the bosses will think of her new rebel character, Professor Troubles.
Is that better?
Yeah. Are you nervous, Hayley?
I've never been worried about anything as much in my life. Ever. Ever. This is the worst.
Yeah. And you're a bit proud of
the band? What's it over? I've never done skin work before. I do really enjoy it, actually.
Stick my head on. I hope I can breathe.
Transformation straight away.
Yay!
Right, let's get ready to rumble.
For the sweat.
If I knew that they knew about the new character and if I think they knew about the story and exactly what's going to happen, then I'd be fine. But the fact that they don't know anything, I mean, what's their reaction going to be like as soon as this new character comes out? Are they going to be like,
I think they'd be surprised, but in a good way, because it's just something new, isn't it?
Well, they can't dislike it, can they? I mean, it's a good story.
How could they not like it?
It's a good story.
It's just different.
So
if they don't like it,
to look at, it's so colourful.
Yeah, if they don't like it, it's just purely because it is different, and they just have to get used to it being a bit different than what they have to.
I think that I've been brought here to change a few things, and I think that I've definitely
done that. And that's what you've
done. Yeah. But whether it's changed for the best, and
I think it is.
I suppose we're going to find out soon enough.
And we'll be finding out what Hayley's bosses think of the new production after the break. Now for our competition. This week we're... Theme designer Victoria Gibb, who's married to Flamingo Land's boss, is checking progress on her pet project, the Muddy Duck Farm.
Only 3 days till we open and only a month's worth of work left to do, which isn't at all scary. This is our new cockerel. and he's called Cyril, and he's really annoying because he crows every 15 minutes very, very loudly, which is, well, I think it's, we're already sick to death of him, and we've had all sorts of workmen threaten to knock him off, kill him, shoot him. He's not real, so it's not going to hurt him any, but I just wonder how long he's going to stay up there. But we should see if the villagers start complaining about him soon. Just in front of us is Muddy Duck Pond, which is neither muddy nor has any ducks in it at the moment, which is a bit worrying. Apart from the animatronic cockerel, we've also got an animatronic pig. Oh, bless her, she's gorgeous. Look, her little eyes flutter, eyelids flutter and everything. So she's got 10 piglets suckling away there. Some of them are spotty and quite cute. What we've done with this is you see it from both ways round when you come round on the tractor ride, which is quite nice. And we've built the roof over so that the views are good and you don't get any sort of rain and the sun doesn't fade or any of those things. So I'm quite excited about this. How cute is she?
Victoria can't spend too long cooing over her plastic pigs. She's due in the Plaza Bar for the boss's preview of the all-new Professor Bubbles show. But when Hayley finds out Victoria's turned up without her husband, park boss Gordon Gibb, she takes it badly.
Gordon apparently isn't coming, which I'm just devastated about. Because I thought that's what it was for, me doing the show and then performing for him to show him what I could do, and he's not coming, so I'm really upset about it.
He's trying to rearrange, but he didn't know until about an hour ago, so... Anyway... We're going to watch, aren't we, son? He's got his bunny ears on today.
But the show must go on, and as it starts, Gordon appears next to his wife.
What are you waiting for? Push the button! Oh, dear. Didn't quite work that time, but we were so close. If you see anything happening behind me, you must shout, Professor Bubbles!
Hayley's hoping the special effects in her revamped show will win the bosses over.
What? Oh, I haven't got time for this. We need to get to work! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, everybody's on here, set them up, let's ride! Yes.
Flamingo Land's big new roller coaster for 2006, Kumali, is about to carry its first ever passenger. Martin Reinfeld from the Dutch company that built the ride will be the test pilot.
I do always the first test run after the G-force measurements and after testing what we did. Yeah. We hope that it is a very good ride. I will test it now. So, hopeful. That I come back again, it is a smiling face, and that I'm satisfied.
No turning back for Martin now. He's about to experience Kumali's G-force. At least ride safety expert Richard Barnes has done his homework and is confident it's safe for humans.
The G-force is just around 4.5G vertical. There's two particular reasons that we're interested in G-forces. The first is for the actual way that the passengers are affected, so that we don't actually cause injuries to people. And you've got to remember that the people who go on these are not fighter pilots. They're not people who are very, very fit. It's got to be suitable for everybody to go on. So we've got to reduce the Gs to a level which is suitable for people to use and ride it safely. But secondly, when the calculations are done for fatigue analysis and the way that the trains behave in over a very long term, we need to know what the vibrations are so that we can work that out in the longevity of the ride.
Very good. Very smooth. Good. Yep. Really happy with it. It's a really smooth ride.
We've not met your nephew, Professor. Is he as clever as you?
Back on stage, Hayley's new character, Professor Troubles, is about to make his first appearance.
I'm here! I'm Troubles, and I'm cool!
Over in the zoo, giraffe keeper Sam DeBell is preparing for a big move.
We're building a new house on the other side of the park, a breeding complex for the giraffes. So we've picked Kismet, our eldest male, to go over there. Kismet is a very handsome 9.5-year-old Rothschild's giraffe. He came here three or four years ago, and since then he's been living with our other two male giraffes. He's quite a rare beastie, so it'd be nice if we could breed off him. So that's why we've chosen him to go over to the other house rather than the other two younger males.
Kismet's reward for moving will be a new girlfriend called Penny, who'll be coming to Flamingoland from Chester Zoo.
Penny's very pretty. I went to see her a few weeks ago, went and met her. She's a bit older than Kismet, nice steady beast. She has bred before, so hopefully we'll have a new family in the not too distant future.
What's going to happen if they don't fancy each other?
I'll have to get Scylla a blind date. I think we'll have to have a blind date giraffe thing.
Let's go! You better push the button!
Back on stage, Gordon and Victoria are about to witness Hayley's most impressive special effect.
Press it now, because I say so!
What's happened? I knew we shouldn't have pushed it. Professor Troubles, are you in there?
I think something's going
wrong. Oh no, he shrunk. What have we done? What will Professor Bubbles say?
Do something, quick, change me back.
We can't. Oh, look, here he comes.
What's wrong, girls? You look worried. You used my machine!
Over at Kumali, operations manager Phil Pritchard is the first in the queue of Flamingoland staff wanting to try the new ride.
It's nice to see the project almost at an end.
Yeah.
So, been really looking forward to this bit. What a view as well, fantastic. We've still got tomorrow as well, so we've got two more days really. Well, off we go. What a view, eh? It's like being in thin air. It's just hanging. Fantastic. Hey, what a sensation. Unbelievable. What do you reckon to that? Oh, that is great. Absolutely superb. That's 5 months hard work and it's worth every bit of it.
What do you want to do next, gang?
I want to go on Velocity.
Yay!
I want to go on Cliffhanger.
Oh, yay! Wow.
I want to go to the Muddy Duck Farm.
Oh. I know, gang. Let's go on my newest ride.
Do you mean the Kamali?
But now it's the moment Hayley's been dreading.
I'll see you next time.
Bye-bye!
Yeah. Yes. I'll just let me move it.
Don't be so worried.
I'm very worried.
I'm not Alan Sugar. Well, quite simply, that's the best one we've ever had.
Yes! Excellent. Couldn't be happier. What more could I want? So, it's all gone brilliantly.
The countdown to the opening of the park has begun in earnest. It could be a long night for some people, but Gordon seems to think it's all going well.
Well, we're 14 and a half hours away from D-Day. And I have to say, it's definitely been the smoothest running I personally have ever had. And I think it's potentially, I'm probably tempting fate by saying this, but potentially the best opening that I can, for one, ever remember.
Find out if Gordon was right to be so confident next time. Here's our competition. Welcome to the show that takes you behind the scenes at Flamingoland Theme Park and Zoo in North Yorkshire at the start of the 2006 summer season. And stay tuned for the chance to win a family break in Newcastle in our competition. It's the first day of the 2006 summer season and the park is open to the public, but the weather isn't exactly, well, summery. Park staff are still busy cleaning up around the site of the new £6 million roller coaster Kumani.
We're virtually there now. We've got all the area cleaned up. We've got to do two test runs in manual mode, which the mechanics are going to do any second now. After that, we'll be doing one test run in automatic, which is the program we're running during the day. And then, fingers crossed, we should be ready to open it up.
In the zoo, Kismet the giraffe is on the move. He's leaving his old housemates, Richard and Stephen, behind to go and live in a brand new breeding unit across the park.
Moving Kismet could be quite a difficult operation. We've been working up towards it for quite a long time. We've had to have a corridor built in the house. We've tried to train Kismet to walk into the corridor with the door shut across, which is necessary. We've got a false wall at the back, which isn't, it doesn't shove him in. It just sort of, as he takes a step forward, he can move it up so he can't back up. There's going to be some staff behind that. It's a heavy old thing, so they should be all right. But the safety of the animal and the safety of the staff is obviously very important. He's not really liked it a great deal, so how today's going to go, I'm not too sure.
A specialist zoo animal removal firm have come from Holland with their equipment to move Kismet just a few hundred yards across the park.
I suppose now the crunch time has come to see if we can actually get him in here with the door shut. As I say, he's been walking through absolutely fine with it open, but like I say, I never work with children and animals, so he's, we'll just see if we're going anyway, just nice and quietly. What a good boy! What a good boy! Good boy! What a clever chap! He's a good boy.
Then, just as things seem to be going so well...
Just one small minor technical hitch. We won't be a couple of minutes. The wall's too wide to go through the door. The scaffolding's just a bit too wide. We're just sewing a bit off and then we'll open up.
Down in the Holiday Village reception, Jill and Michael Ennis, their daughter Sarah, and twin nieces Charlotte and Alexandra are checking in for a weekend break in a log cabin.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Party of Ennis checking in.
Thank you.
Have you stayed with us before?
No.
Yeah, straight out reception to the bottom and turn left. The road just follows straight the way around, and left again, I'll take them to the log cabins.
Right.
Who's got the keys?
Alex.
In we go.
Wow.
Amazing.
Wow.
She's got better Corbetton than the others.
Wow.
Oh, TV.
Watching machine. Fantastic.
I shouldn't have brought me spare underpants in if there's a washing machine.
Oh, we're going to leave him at home the next time, aren't we? And the freezer. Come on, let's go through
and
see what the bedroom's like.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I'll never fit in that bath. Ta-da!
Shower!
Tally in the bedroom.
This is fantastic.
This is my Huffy room.
I think I can live here.
It's better than our bedroom at home.
Hey, I worked hard on that bedroom. Behave yourself. It's good. It's lovely. It really is.
It's better than home, really.
I'll tell you what's missing, Joe.
Yeah?
A little table here for me beer.
Oh. I'm probably just better opening the front door and see if he goes.
Back at the giraffe house, the carpenters have done their work and the team are ready for the off.
Hello! We're going to open the front door and then, if he needs it, we'll open the back one and shove him in.
Good boy.
There's a clever lad. How are you doing?
Good boy.
Bit more. Bit more, he won't get out.
Oostjan Kip specialises in moving exotic animals all over the world.
The keepers had built already a really nice corridor. We put the trailer in front and then slowly, slowly, with a piece of wood, every step he did forwards, he couldn't go back.
Good boy. Right, go forwards a bit more.
Yes! Come on, big man. Yes, come on. Come on, big man, it's the only way to go. Come on. Right. Steady, steady, good boy. Whoa, we're nearly in. We're in. Yes.
With Kismet safely on board, Ernst could take his extra tall trailer on a very short ride.
So that went really smooth and then it was only 200 meters.
Over at Kumali, the new roller coaster, the big moment has almost arrived.
Come
in. There's a bit of divert. New passengers there, up to you.
Yeah, we're a couple of runs away from putting people on, but they can start queuing.
Hey, what's the right name called?
Kumali.
Kumali. I don't hear it.
Kumali.
Louder.
Kumali.
I don't hear it.
Kumali.
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 Been waiting for this a long time. Really excited about it.
Bring the platform down. You will stop you there.
Can you tell me how it is in
work, please? Okay.
Our job is done now,
Your job is done, my friend.
Yes.
Yes.
Viewers at home, be jealous.
Josh and Simon live locally and have been following Kumali's progress as it was built.
Bye.
Bye.
They're very pleased to be the first members of the public on the new ride.
I've been searching Kumali for about half a year. I've come here taking pictures. I've seen it from the groundwork up to what it is now. I think it's awesome. I think it's a magnificent structure and a brilliant feat. Well, here we go then. Off we go! Woo! Oh, wow! Oh, that is good! That feels pretty weird. Oh, my God! Woo! Oh, yeah, that's quite good. Woo! It's like I'm flying! There it is! That was really good.
At the zoo's new giraffe house, there's no sign yet of the travelling Kismet or his Dutch driver.
He's just been taken out of the park, around and back into the park another way. Obviously, it's quite a tall trailer and we have to watch because we have the monorail and stuff. So they're being escorted round and hopefully, any minute, he should appear. Then we've just got to unload him, which hopefully shouldn't be as much of a trial.
Park boss Gordon Gibb hasn't been caged for the day. He's just here to see how the move goes.
Should be.
Oh, there we are. Come on. Here's. Oh, what a good boy. What a good boy. Here you go. Good boy.
And we'll find out how Kismet gets on with his new mate, Penny, after the break. National competition. The Ennis family from Newcastle are spending the weekend in one of Flamingoland's log cabins.
Few minor teething problems, Hoover tubes blocked. Yeah, cooker hood this morning when we went to cook the kids' breakfast. All the controls were pushed up inside.
Yeah, you just expect a little bit more. That's all when everything costs so much, don't you?
Oh yeah.
We also had the problem with the dirty sheets last night. Fortunately, we had one spare, so you really don't expect to have, you know, something like that on really these days. So, not too good, really.
Unfortunately, due to the high turnover of caravans and log cabins that we have, mistakes do happen. In the case of the Ennis family, as you can see here, they did have a linen problem. It's all brand new linen into the log cabins, and this small amount of, I'm not quite sure what it is, has not been spotted there. They also had a problem with their Hoover. We have checked the Hoover in itself, so the Hoover bag had been replaced, but there was a blockage in the pipe, which unfortunately we hadn't seen. And the cooker hood also had a problem with some buttons pushed in, again, which had been overlooked, and all we can do is apologise for that. But we do say to our guests when they check in, if there's any problems at all, please call back to reception so we can rectify those for you, because we certainly don't want our guests messing with anything that we truly don't know about.
Putting their problems behind them, the Ennis family choose the attractions they most want to see today.
Water ride.
Yes, we can go on the water ride. I'm just having a look to see what's on. There's a sea lion show. Does anybody fancy that?
No.
Bird show?
No.
No? African acrobat show?
No.
You just want to go on the rides, don't you?
Yeah.
Can we go on the cars?
The Muddy Duck Farm.
And then go on the big rides.
Oh, look.
It's closed. We can't go on it. We're just going to have to go somewhere else instead.
Not the peacocks on the lane, this ride will not be working.
It's got a little baby clinging onto its tummy.
And so cute.
That's a one, Rob.
£12 then, please.
Oh my goodness me. Did you see Sarah with a monkey?
If we'd have had breakfast, we'd have been sick by now.
Talk about breakfast.
We definitely need her on for that. And then one two over, shots over.
Over
there.
At Kumali, the park's brand new roller coaster, a film crew are hard at work.
And move closer in. And
so, how many do we need her on? Because she's going to start throwing up on the ride, and that won't be good. My name's Phil Hawkins, and I'm a director for the Gate Films. Spin around. Having interviews.
What? Right, you. Told you before, no hanging around, get back on set!
Is it good? Have you got any ducks going on? Yeah. Oh, cool. What is he like? I'll fire him. Sorry, what am I doing here today? We are here today shooting the commercial for Flamingo Land, which is obviously their new ride, the Kumalo, and a few other different things. So the legs have come up to about there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you've got to do it.
Cool.
Yeah. Is it sure, Phil?
We need to go back on.
Yeah, yeah, no worries. Yeah, we're going to need you back on.
Oh, oh no.
The park's marketing director, Melanie Wood, has masterminded the campaign.
We brought your perfect family in today for the shooting.
Oh no, not enough. I feel sick.
In the past, what I have done is utilise some staff to be the characters in our commercials, but when you spend so much money on a new commercial, I just felt that it was worth spending a little bit more just so we get it spot on and perfect.
There's
three children, different ages, so we can see Flamingo Land from, you know, different age groups. We've got a mum and a dad, so hopefully they'll do a good job for us today.
How many times have you been on the ride?
Five. This is my sixth time.
Legs come in and bang, that's it.
That's it.
That's it, perfect.
We have to send our poor actors around about 50 times, so they have to keep looking like they're excited. And, you know, each ride takes 10 minutes, so it takes a while to shoot what is a 10-second advert. But it should be fine, it should be great.
Just crash in for me, Rich. Certainly. Do a little snap zoom in.
We're just going to do that again, to try and get like a little crash zoom in, to try and pick up some screaming faces. And then we're going over to this bit, which is it's all about finding shapes in the ride. And we'll come down and look underneath, so we'll get faces as they twist around and come right through camera, so we'll just get those legs, and it should be all good. Little girl, our leading girl, has been on it a few too many times and thrown up in the loo, drinking too much lemonade and going out too many times in between takes. She's a nutter. I've not been on it once yet, but she's about to go on it again.
Go on, Chloe.
I'll do it.
Hey.
Come on,
sweetie.
Go around. Get you off my phone.
In the zoo, Kismet the giraffe is waiting to welcome his new housemate, a female called Penny, to the new breeding enclosure.
He settled in really well. We came in this morning, checked him last night and he was fine. Came in this morning and it was like just normal. Hello, came over, where's my breakfast? So, yeah, he settled in really nicely. So, Penny's arrived anyway, so we'll see how she unloads, hopefully just as good as yesterday, and then we'll see how they react to each other. Holy, I've got a girly coming. Here's your hat.
Here in Flamingo Mountland, they have an enclosure for only male giraffes. It's on the other side of the zoo, and they had three males there, and they built here a very nice new house, and they want to have a breeding group here, so male with females. So yesterday I took the male from the male enclosure to here, to the breeding facility. And today I went to the Zoo of Chester to collect the female and bring it here. So they have now a couple.
Penny's a bit reluctant to come out of the trailer, but with a little gentle coaxing from Ernst and Sam, she finally steps out into her new home.
Hello, sweetheart. Come on then. That's a good girl.
The female now, she's more nervous. So that's why we decided today put the trailer in the house in front of the box. So she doesn't have to look for their way. She's immediately in her own box.
Good girl. Good girl. Come on then. It's all right, good girl, come on. Oh, good girl. Good girl. Have you finally noticed there's somebody else here?
Yeah. He doesn't care, he has something.
He's got his food, not bothered, no. Kismet's not actually noticed her because I've fed him, so he's not. He's just been like, oh, what's a girl? Where's my dinner? But Kismet's never met a lady giraffe before. She sort of like glanced over and said, oh, it's a boy, and that's about it. But it's early days yet. We'll see how they get on together. Yeah, she took a little while to come out, but that's fair enough. It's all new. So yeah, chuffed a bit, feel a lot better, and now we can get on with looking after the animals.
I think Graham's lost the will to live, you say.
Who's in charge of will to live, guys?
The crew filming the new Flamingo Land TV commercial have moved from Kumali across to the park's other new attraction, Muddy Duck Farm.
It's been going well. I mean, we're slightly behind, but not by much, so we'll catch it up later on. But this is the thing about rides, is that you have to wait for them to do their full circuit. And the Kumali, that's fine, because it only takes about a minute and a half, but this one takes about 5 minutes to get round. It's a fantastic ride for kids. I'll say that officially. We're on sticks next. One more shot here, guys, and then we're moving on.
Enjoy that, Mike.
It's a bit frightening.
Over at Velocity, Flamingoland's fastest ride, staff are having to make an unusual announcement.
Anyone with false teeth? Can you take them off, please?
Well, we were just queuing to go on the Velocity, and then there was a bit of a kerfuffle. Somebody had lost their false teeth on the ride, so they had the ride shut down to see if they could find them. Apparently they found them, but whether they're in one piece or not, I doubt very much. So now they're advising people to remove loose clothing, hats, glasses, and dentures. Shouldn't laugh really, but.
And if you got false teeth, can you take them out? Or you're losing that ye?
Thankfully, the false teeth were recovered by staff and returned to their grateful owner. Here is Ernie the Young Hippo is continuing to do well after his groundbreaking operation, but he's still spending a lot of time with his mum and aunt. Zazie the lioness has given birth to four cubs, fathered by Kumali, which no one, not even park bosses, have been allowed to see yet. Love seems to be blossoming between Kismet and Penny the giraffes. They're said to be very fond of each other. The revamped Professor Bubbles show's been a hit with the holidaymakers, but Hayley the choreographer is still waiting to move into the bigger flat she was promised earlier in the year. Stop.